We're learning new details about a man suspected of killing one man and injuring another in a separate hit and run. Police believe Scott Ruffcorn drove off after killing Vernon Burton on the Stores Expressway early Sunday morning. KETV News Watch 7's Andrian Whitsett is live at the Douglas County Jail.
Brandy, Scott Ruffcorn remains behind bars this evening here at the Douglas County Jail. He's right now been arrested and remains in jail for misdemeanor, motor vehicle homicide, and felony leaving the scene of an accident. Douglas County Attorney Don Klein says that he will file charges tomorrow or Wednesday. Now, it only took officers a few hours to find Ruffcorn, and the officer who found him first says he's glad to see Ruffcorn behind bars. Less than 6 hours after this accident, a hit and run on the Stores Expressway, police found their suspect, Scott Ruffcorn.
I was not going to give up.
Officer Adam Roke says he would have searched all day, but after 45 minutes using pieces of the vehicle left at the scene, Officer Roakes found what he was looking for.
The fresh damage on the vehicle, I knew right then I had the right one.
Police believe Scott Ruffcorn drove this vehicle, killing Vernon Burton as he changed a friend's tire on the expressway. Daryl Avant was helping Burton. He's hospitalized with serious injuries. For Officer Roakes, the case is similar to another hit and run last week near 37th and Q. Roakes arrested the suspect in that case as well.
These drivers fled the scene without stopping, without rendering aid. In my opinion, I have a lot more incentive to catch these people.
We checked Scott Ruffcorn's record. He spent 18 months in prison after his fifth DUI in 2006 and has several driving under suspension charges, including one from January of this year. Ruffcorn also served sentence for weapons possession. Officer Roakes is just glad to see a suspected careless driver off the street.
I don't want to see these people get away with something, especially something this serious.
And Officer Roakes says normally in a fatal hit and run investigation, catching a suspect early usually helps the family get some closure. Coming up tonight at 6, we hear from Vernon Burton's family and why having a suspect in custody doesn't give them much closure right now. Reporting live near 17th and Jones, Andrian Whitsett, KETV News Watch 7.